Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Welcome to our program, Musical Corner for All. Today, I would like to introduce our December theme, Poetic Winds of Seasons, Spring, Summer, Autumn, and Winter. From ancient times, humans have observed natural phenomena and their own inner state, which was reflected in all classical art forms, with roots going to ancient Greece and Rome. Music, poetry, and art, all paths through their historical styles, influencing time and preserving laws of beauty. One of the first prominent mentions of seasons in art can be found in Roman Emperor Nero's Domus Aurea, or Golden Palace, in a revolving banquet hall in the form of mosaic. The design was inspired by Ovid's epic narrative poem, Metamorphoses, Description of the Palace of the Sun. Here it is. Wearing a purple robe, Phoebus sat on throne, shining with the bright emeralds. To right and left stood the day, month, and year, the century, and the equally spaced hours. Young spring stood there circled with a crown of flowers. Late summer wore a garland of ears of corn. Autumn was stained by the trodden grapes, and icy winter had white bristling hair. Let's see now what Nero had in his palace. The fragment of the original mosaic is in the center, excavated at Domus Aurea in Rome. You will recognize seasons by their attributes: spring with a wreath of flowers, summer with sheaf of wheat, winter with dry thistles, and autumn with bunches of grapes. On the sides, you can see seasons mosaic from the other Roman villas. Many hundreds of years later, this theme is used again by the Limburg brothers in the 15th century, by Flemish and Dutch master painters of the 16th century, and by Italian Manierist painter Giuseppe Arcimboldo. And you may see now Arcimboldo's paintings on your screen. These paintings are an allegory or image with a hidden meaning of four seasons. They symbolize stages of human life: childhood, youth, maturity, and old age. Young female spring is made of wide variety of flowers. Summer, in her prime, dressed in a garment of straw, is made of fruits and vegetables. Autumn, the hourly man, is made of ripe fruit and vegetables. Winter, a wrinkled old man, is composed of old log and branches covered by a simple straw mat. Short time later, an Italian painter, Francesco Sozzi, and an Italian composer, Antonio Vivaldi, both representing late Baroque period, have again used this theme, the theme of seasons. Francesca Sozzi created the Four Seasons, a cycle of four frescoes at Palazzo Isnello, where seasons are represented by figures from Roman mythology. You may see Sozzi's Four Seasons on your screen. Spring, in an image of Venus, is in the center. Winter on the left, personified by the god Aulus. On the right are the summer in the image of Ceres and the autumn Dionysus. All four frescoes were arranged in the shape of the butterfly's wing. Now, Antonio Vivaldi composes a cycle of 12 violin concerti named The Contests Between Harmony and Invention. The first four concerti of his cycle give musical expressions to the seasons of the year, accompanied by a poetic sonnet, which is a poetic form of 14 lines, known since the 13th century. Each of these concertos is composed in late Italian Baroque style. During this period appeared homophonic style with one main voice. Concertos are for solo violin, string ensemble, and basso continuo, means freedom of improvisation by accompaniment. First concerto consists of three parts. Allegro, the spring has come, meaning of March. Largo e pianissimo, sleeping shepherd, means April. And Allegro danze pastorale, this is a country dance and old Italian dance saltarello, meaning of May. Please listen to the spring sonnet. It just pretty much look like that. The first part, Allegro. Springtime is upon us. The birds celebrate her return with festive song, and murmuring streams are softly caressed by the breezes. Thunderstorms, those heralds of spring, roar, casting their dark mantle over heaven. Then they die away to silence, and the birds take up their charming songs once more. The next part, Largo. On the flower-strewn meadow with leafy branches rustling overhead, the goatherd sleeps his faithful dog beside him. And third, last part, Allegro. Led by the festive sound of rustic bagpipes, nymph and shepherds lightly dance beneath the brilliant canopy of spring. The form is built around alternation of solo violin and accompaniment in a Baroque style, with sounds of nature and music, elegant, refined, virtuoso, and technically complex. You will now listen to the Spring by Vivaldi. The Spring by Vivaldi was performed by Vienna Philharmonic Ensemble with Herbert von Karajan as conductor and Anne-Sophie Mutter as a violin solo. Nobody can do everything, jest and terrify, cause laughter or move profoundly like Joseph Haydn. This is what Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart said about the music of Joseph Haydn, who was one of the founders of Vienna Classical School in the 18th century. Haydn's work is linked to high point of symphony from the Greek symphonia, meaning agreement or concord of sound, where composer can express by musical means philosophical and ethical ideas. Haydn's symphonies are interesting in his development of main themes, conducting his melody through different tonalities and registers, giving it different moods. Haydn invented symphonies and sonatas in four parts, which differ in music character, tempo, and development. One example is his oratorio. It's a large musical composition for orchestra, choir, and soloists, known since the 17th century, just like the opera, but without action on stage. Haydn's The Seasons has libretto based on a poem by English poet James Thomson from the same period. Summer is the second part. Just listen to. From brightening fields of ether fair disclosed, child of the sun, refulgent summer comes in pride of youth and felt through nature's depth. He comes attended by the sultry hours and ever fanning breezes on his way, while from his ardent look the turning spring averts her blushful face, and earth and skies all smiling to his hot dominion leaves. On your screen you can see the period German painters John Christian Fiedler's Four Seasons, Allegory of Summer. Fresh green vegetables represent the first summer crop. White and dark dresses of the two women symbolize day and night, as well as heaven and earth. You will now listen to the opening pieces from The Summer by Haydn. Here, for the first time, the orchestra acts as the poet, painter, and dramatist. The introduction depicts the sunrise from the dark night, followed by three vocal soloists, bass, tenor, and soprano. Melody here develops in a slow rhythm, resembling a slow Baroque saraband dance. As the tempo quickens, you can hear the first rays of the sun, and the sound of horn announces the true morning, full of life and energy. Melody of the bass is styled as the German folk song, and soprano begins the new day as a hymn to the sun.
grauem Schleier rückt heran das sanfte Morgenlicht. Schritten weicht vor ihm die träge Nacht zurück. Vögel blinde Schar. Ihr dumpfer Klageton beklemmt das bange
des Tages Herold meldet sich. Mit scharfem Laute rufet zu neuer Tätigkeit den ausgeruhten Landmann auf. Welchen Ehre gegen Hart.
Selected pieces from the summer by Joseph Haydn was performed by Vienna Symphony with Carl Böhm as conductor. Alexander Glazunov's ballet, The Seasons, was commissioned by the director of the Imperial Theatre and is styled after the court ballet of the 17th century with libretto and choreography by Marios Petipa. Alexander Glazunov was a Russian composer of the late 19th and early 20th century. He based his composition on his philosophical idea to realize one of the favorite myths of mankind, the myth of eternal resurrection of nature from winter sleep and of life-giving power of the sun. The Seasons is a single act ballet in four tableaux. Each defines the season of the year: winter, spring, summer, and autumn. The scents are happening in the nature with the fantastic dances of images. Winter with his companions, hoarfrost, ice, hail, and snow. Spring with warm wind, zephyr, flower, fairies, and enchanted birds. Summer with naiads, satyrs, and fauns. Autumn with all season gathered together and joining in harvesting grapes. In his music, the composer masterfully uses ingenious descriptive means of the large orchestra to imitate sounds of hail, soft falling of snowflakes, and languor of the hot summer day. Each tableau has its own musical theme developed in a musical narrative. In autumn, the last part of these themes appear again, achieving closure and link with previous scenes. At the end of the 19th century, the new style Art Nouveau is born. One of the representatives of this style was Czech painter Alphonse Mucha. On your screen, you will see his interpretation of the Seasons and women's images. Please note that Mucha, as well as the next artist, begin their season cycle with winter, just like Glazunov. At the same time, in the same Art Nouveau style, French painter Elizabeth Sonreille creates her woman images, The Seasons. Now you may see Sonreille's Seasons on your screen, and we'll now listen to the autumn tableau from Glazunov's The Seasons.
Thank you.
Autumn Tableau from the Seasons by Alexander Glazunov was performed by Czech Slavic Orchestra with Andrei Lenard as conductor. Continuing the theme of the seasons, I would like to introduce to you two 20th century masters. For me, seasons represent human life, both physical and spiritual, at its different ages. I hope that the people will feel the same emotion that I felt when doing this work. These words belong to Marc Chagall about his monumental Four Seasons mosaic created for the city of Chicago. I have dedicated Cuatro Estaciones Parfenias to those who live in dark portside alleys of Buenos Aires, where the Argentinian tango was born. This is not just the change of the seasons, this is life in her different stages. These words belong to Astor Piazzolla about his Four Seasons of Buenos Aires. His compositions have enriched the style of tango, which has combined the elements of jazz, Afro-Hispanic flavors, and classical music, and is now known as the Tango Nuevo. Our last season today, Invierno Porteño, Buenos Aires Winter, by Astor Piazzolla and Marc Chagall's mosaic. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Buenos Aires Winter by Piazzolla was performed by Marie Samuelsen on violin, Hakon Samuelsen on cello, and Trondheim Solists, Norway. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, my holiday greetings to everyone, and happy new seasons to all. Thank you.